what we want to do is just take a look at what happened, and I'll just go over what I just said. Basically, if you see the Asian markets, they were all very, very nicely up, but Europe is a little soft. And so you'll see that our futures are also softening from its high level. And so I'll take this out of the picture again, and so we can focus on charts. If you look at the previous day's session, which was on Friday was a strong day. And so it's in India, it starts at 8 p.m., which is 20 hours. Okay, so you may see times like this, and the markets end at 2:30 a.m. in India. And so you'll see that the general open market open hours are between 8 p.m. and 2:30 a.m. here. Also, you'll see that the biggest opportunity for day trading comes right at the market open. And so, you know, if you look at 20 hours here, 8 p.m., you'll see that some of the biggest moves come at the market open. And so that is one time you want to take advantage. After that, the big traders go for lunch and things like that. And then, you know, of course, there can be some pretty good action in the afternoons as well. But basically what it is, you know, you want to, and for a day trade, you want to take advantage of the market open. Now, that doesn't mean that you have to go into the trade as soon as the market opens. We just need to study the sentiment a little bit. And so very often you'll see that the market open really presents the best opportunities. Basically, what we did even on Friday, I think most of the trades that I've taken, the sample trade videos that I've made, are all just a little bit after the market open. But today, as you can see, we are just up about 250. So it's a very, it's a very muted opening for the day. And so let me go back here. So every day in the morning, when you see these, please bear in mind that this is the signal sentiment as of the close of the previous day. And you'll see that as soon as the market opens, all of this will start changing, right away, immediately. So that's one thing to keep in mind. And so we'll keep an eye out for Netflix, Tesla, and Boeing on the bullish side. And then on the bearish side, what we want to do is, in case the S&P starts going negative, then what might be a good put option trade would actually be Amazon, because Amazon might show that it's up 30 bucks, you know, in the pre-market. But if the S&P is going down, it's going to give away some of those gains from those $30. And so, a small put option trade might not be too bad. And the thing with Amazon is they have very expensive options, and so are Google, and so is Booking. So these three stocks, as well as the SPX index itself. So these are stocks where you just want to take very small contracts and also go out a little bit on the delta, whether it's on the call side or the put side. You want to go out to no more than about 30, 32 delta. Otherwise, these smaller stocks, we can easily go up to 35 to 40 delta. Okay, it's just opened, and let's see, the ES is right there, and it's moved into bullish, into very bullish. That's good. So we have Google, we have Tesla, and Tesla is moving up 4.78. Netflix is moving up 4.67. But you can see the ES is softening a little bit. And so this was what I was sort of concerned about, whether it might take a little breather. But what happens usually is either it takes off in one direction at the open, or it does a fake out. And so in the sense of a fake out, meaning now you can see the bar going down on the S&P, but within this, either this bar or the next bar, it will turn around and go up. So those are the two general popular ways that the markets open. One is it just shoots off in one direction and that's it. You know, it's gone. And that's what happened on Friday. But today it might do somewhat of a fake out. It wants to go up, but then it wants to make sure that, you know, there's not a whole lot of selling going on. So that's also possible here. But as soon as we get a decent signal on one of these, you can see Tesla is also pulling back just like the S&P there. I'm going to zoom in slightly on Tesla as well. And let's just take a look at Netflix as well. And also Netflix is, So Netflix is actually looking stronger than Tesla, if you can see the chart. So between the two, I would say Netflix might be a better option. Let's see, Boeing has also moved into very bullish. So let's take a look at Boeing as well. But Boeing is pulling back along with the S&P. So at least so far, it looks like Netflix might be the best opportunity right here. And you can see now the S&P is trying to move up over past that fake, you know, what I'm calling a fake out. So if that's the case, if it moves up nicely over there, then what we would do is try to take a trade on Netflix, because out of the three, I think Netflix is looking pretty good. So let's just wait and see what happens here. So the first bar is not very convincing either way, bullish or bearish. Netflix is still looking bullish. If this goes clearly into the green on the ES, then I think that would give some confidence to take Netflix as the trade for the day. Netflix, yeah, it is moving there, and Netflix has gone up by $6. So what I'm going to do is go to Netflix and let's look at, we got 4 days left. That's perfect. So we have, let's say, about a 36 delta. So I'm just going to put this here, five contracts. This would be about a $2,500 trade. But while we keep this ready, I just want to make sure that, you know, the markets also don't change on us. Okay. All right. So we are in at 510 on Netflix. And so let's go back to our market watch. Now what we'll do is, you know, we've got Netflix on the bottom left, and we've got the S&P on the top left. And so let's just watch these two and see how this develops. So Netflix is moving up. Now it's up about 7.24. What do we have? About $200 up. And here we are. Netflix is going up again. And there is the ES also seems to be recovering a little bit. Let's see how we stand. 225, not too bad, not too bad, especially given that the S&P is showing a little bit of weakness. So here we are. This Netflix is going past 305.42. And so let's just see what our situation is. Okay, $250, $300, not bad. Now it's punching up even more higher. And so here we go, 375. So let's just keep an eye out on the profit, because so it's a $2,500 trade. So, you know, a $500 profit would be like about a 20% you know, ROI on that. Obviously, if the momentum is strong, you can hold on to the trade, but looks like, you know, there's going to be some wobbliness in the markets today. It's not the kind of market where it's going to just charge in one direction. That's not going to happen. So I would much rather take the profits, even a 15-20% return, take it. And so, you know, in my opinion, I've done this, testing on these things. The best thing is you take the trade at the open, at the market open, and you know, if you get a decent profit, you take the profit and you close out for the day. Okay, you close out for the day. That's the best way to consistently build the account on a daily basis. The more you trade, the more the markets will soften or turn back, and the momentum will go away, and all that sort of stuff, you know, starts happening. And so you tend to give back what you made as you do more and more. It's like the casinos. You go into the casinos to play blackjack. The more you play, the more chances you have of giving back whatever winnings that you might have had in the first place. So here we go. So here we are at 450. Netflix looking okay, S&P looking okay, so we can still hang in the trade. Let's go see what we have on the signals. They should, I believe, should all be still in the very bullish. That's great. And so now the S&P wants to move higher. And so this should take Netflix hopefully higher along with it. So we are at 305. Let's see what profits we have. Now, also one more thing you can do is you can scale out of it. So instead of selling all five contracts, let's say you want to capture some profit. So each one can, you know, take this kind of decision. I'll say, okay, let me sell two at, let's say, 605, right? I mean, we have, let's see, what is the profit here? Okay, 489. And so here we have at six, at 595, 590. You know, if you want to take a little bit of profit, you can, say, two contracts. And let's just, I'm just showing what you can do so that, you know, I think it just moved up a little bit. So here we are, and so P&L for the day and P&L open. So we've captured some profit, so that's good. So we have three contracts left over here. And so let's put that over here. And so there we go. So now we are at 306. And so if you look at our profits now here, it's gone up to about 559 totally for the day. And we've already booked some, and it's gone up to 630, 665. So why not? I mean, you know, take another contract off and do 670. Let's do... And let's sell one contract. I mean, because it's good to take these profits, because these signals can change. I mean, this is a day trading environment, and so these signals can change. And so at 650, I might want to take one. I got 660 for that. Not bad. You know, if it doesn't, if it's showing some weakness, here you go. It's showing some weakness. I'm closing it. Okay, so that's it. you know, let's take what we have and let's not get too greedy. 6.65. Just watch this here. Yeah, S&P is going down. So I'm just going to close it. 6.85. All right, so we are in at 6.95. We got it. We got exact $700, guys. Okay, so this is how you would, you know, take advantage of this. Now you can see there's some, you know, it's some flatlining going on over here. So do you consider scaling? Yeah. No, not if the trade is going in your favor. I wouldn't do it. But if it's not going in your favor, then I would consider doubling down one time. That's it. But not if it's going in your favor, because these things can change any time, guys. Okay, they can change. Like this one can change any time. I mean, ES is still showing very bullish, but I wouldn't be surprised if this continues, that ES drops either to the neutral or to the bullish side. Okay, so you got to understand the algorithms are day trading algorithms, so they look back no more than about 20, 25, 30 period, you know, things like that. And so small changes in price action can take the signal away. And so, you know, I would say don't scale in if your position is going in your favor. You put in a five contract position, if that's your size, if you put in a five contract position, that should generate enough profit. So, you know, it'll make your worth, you know, it'll make your time worthwhile. So here you are, now it's gone to seven, but that's okay. I mean, you can't second guess yourself. You had a good trade, and that's how you have to look at these things.